This is TWiT.
Newsletters, while I like them,
they fill up your...
They fill, mm-hmm. yes. Yeah. And so I thought, what if there was an app that would just be newsletters, sort of like one of the old reader apps, but for newsletters? Because a lot of people, like, I love our newsletter. I love Kevin Rose's newsletter. There are so many different newsletters, like people that I just enjoy. Maybe it's not even a specific topic, but they come up with, they sort of find the web. I know it's old fashioned, but I like it. So there is an app. It's called Stoop. And here it is, Stoop.
Stoop.
So I can, here are all the newsletters that I've subscribed to, and I can...
How do you get them in there?
You want me to show you?
Yeah.
Here's a plus. I get a plus. I'm going to add a newsletter. So I could go through popular topics.
I need this.
New to Stoop.
Because I don't want to really jam my email with newsletters.
No, you don't. So marketing but good. I like this. They're going to sell you something the
but
new old-fashioned way.
But it's okay.
So like, for example, Unsplash. We've talked about Unsplash before. They're the website that has free high-res photos that you can use, and then they're delivered right to your inbox. I really like that. So I've already subscribed to that. Let me see.
I'm getting this right now because there are many newsletters I want to subscribe to, but I don't want to jam my inbox.
Right. So let's, and there's paid newsletters too.
Can you add one arbitrarily, or does it have to be in the Stoop index?
You can add one arbitrarily, but I think you have to do something. I think, because I looked and I'm not sure that we have, I think the newsletter creator has to do something on there because I didn't find
we're not
TWiT,
in there.
So I'm going to talk to Patrick about it to get us in there. But you can, like if you have a topic, tech. Well, it's going to show me all these, but you could, yeah, as long as the person has added it, you can, ask Leo. Where's that?
Yeah, it's some other Leo.
Oh, that's Leo Nottenboom?
Yeah.
I don't want that.
Yeah.
Some other, why is anyone asking anybody but you this?
I don't know. I'll never understand.
You know, do you, like Ben Thompson.
Oh, I see how you do it. When you want to subscribe... So when you signed up for Stoop, you got a special stoopinbox.com address.
Yes.
So you could subscribe.
Yes,
you could go to any newsletter and subscribe. Yeah. I got Leo Laporte at stoopinbox.com.
Right. And
which,
then
by the way, now that I've given that out, is going to make this useless because wags in the audience will immediately subscribe me to a bunch of newsletters I don't want to read. So I'll use some other email address.
Yeah, use some other. So yes, that is true. But then it also makes it, so let's say, you know what? I am not going to read this parenting newsletter. I don't care. I can just, archive it and it's gone. And then I go on to the next one, the Product Hunt newsletter. And so here also what I like, it'll tell me how many issues I have unread. And you can set it, say like if I have 5 unread issues of Tasty Make Ahead Meal Plan from BuzzFeed, I don't want that anymore. If I haven't read 5, I'm never going to read them. So it just makes them disappear, which is nice. Your
this
email
is awesome.
Will do that.
Mm-hmm.
I really like it. And you can see the icons over here. So like I have the wire cutter and you can unsubscribe through here too. So it's called Stoop. It is free.
$10 if you want a year, if you want some premium features like a dark UI, support for Pocket and Instamat paper and things like that. But
and then, you can...
No ads.
Or like you can also get notifications, start a discussion. So like let's say I want to say to Jason, look what I found in the Product Hunt newsletter. This robot startup just raised $940 million.
I finally have somewhere I can subscribe to newsletters and it won't jam up my email.
Right.
Plus, it's a nice, it looks nice.
Mm-hmm. It does really look nice.
Because I don't, for one of the things, I don't use HTML in my emails. I think that's dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
I discourage everybody from doing that because it allows you to put malicious content into an email.
Mm-hmm.
So mine's text only, which means most newsletters really don't look very good.
Right.
But this way I could put it in my Stoop. And read in my Stoop.
Yeah.
Reading
a
Stoop.
And then, okay, I'm going to read you. I'll meet you on the Stoop.
Because newsletters are kind of like the new podcast or the new blog.
People are crazy. I've been thinking about starting my own. Everybody
own
wants
newsletter.
To do newsletters.
Right. I mean, if this thing doesn't work out, this whole podcast network, you'll have the newsletter.
You know why I didn't? Because again, you got to write something.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, you.
Remember when everybody was starting their blogs?
Yeah.
And 6 months later, their blogs had an update 4 months ago. And
So the key to this is actually going back to the Stoop. Because you don't want it to turn into an Insta paper or paper or all those things, which you just, I'm going to save that to read for later. And you never do.
I love this. That's good.
For your Stoop.
I just paid for premium. Love it. Nice pick.